So you've got your first hand plane and you've realised it doesn't cut quite like it used to. The shavings are thicker than soup, and so you found you need to learn how to sharpen the thing. Now there's a million ways you can go about sharpening these things, all the way from using sandpaper to expensive Japanese whetstones. But the most effective way I've found when teaching people who've never before sharpened to a razor's edge is by using a diamond stone, a honing guide, and a leather strap. So with these three simple pieces of kit, we can take our edges from unusable to hair shaving sharp, all without breaking the bank. So the first fella we're going to talk about is the diamond stone. The reason I picked him over, let's say, an oil stone or a whetstone is because you need to use less lubrication, they tend to last longer, and after a bit of use, the whetstones or the oil stones tend to go a bit concave, so it's just more hassle to be worrying about when you're starting off. So we'll put them aside and we're going to be using a diamond stone. So these fellas are relatively inexpensive. I think this one was about 35 euros and it has two sides in it. There's one that's 400 grit and we're going to use that at the start to grind our primary bevel. The other side then is 1000 grit and we're going to use that to sharpen the important edge, the secondary bevel, and that's the one you actually do your cutting with. Now you can get stones that'll go up to thousands of grit, but for most uses, pretty much every use I've ever had, 1000 grit is more than enough to take very clean, very thin shavings. So next up we have the honing guide. So this little piece of kit will hold our iron at a specific angle when we're sharpening it on the stone. Now eventually when you get very good, you'll be able to do this without the honing guide, but when you're starting off, you want it to be able to hold it in 30 degrees for you. You can get these for about 10, 15 euros depending. So look out for them. They're definitely worth your while when you're starting off. So next up we have the leather strop. It's essentially a piece of leather glued onto a piece of wood, and we use that when we're finished honing on the stone to remove the burr, which we'll talk about in a minute, and also it leaves a polished finish. So you can make these for free if you look out for a scrap piece of leather, and you'll probably have a piece of wood lying about the place. Glue them together, I find the fluffy side up works better. You can also use stropping compound, which is essentially really fine grit paste to leave a polished edge, but you can get by without it, but it does speed up the process, so if you see it, you might as well pick it up. So now that we know what we're working with, it's time to do the sharpening. So we'll just pop our lever cap off here. If that doesn't come off, just unscrew that one there and it should pop off fairly easily. And then that'll reveal our iron and our chip breaker. Removing the iron from the chip breaker, fairly straightforward. Just unscrew this fella, push them forward and pop them apart and set them aside so we just have the iron on its own. So we have our honing guide here. We're going to use it to sharpen the iron to 25 degrees. We can see on the side of the honing guide here that in order to do that, we need to project the iron by 50 millimeters. So I have a ruler down here. We're just going to use that to line it up. And once we have it at 50 millimeters, we can lock the thing into place with our screwdriver here. So I have the diamond stone here at 400 grit and I have the iron in the guide. So we're just going to move it back and forwards until we get the whole edge to 25 degrees. If a blade is really dull, it might take us maybe even quarter of an hour, but this is fairly sharp already, so this should only take me a few minutes. So a few minutes later, we have the edge brought to 25 degrees and that's us done with the 400 grit side. We can now turn around to the 1000 grit side and we're going to flatten the back and do our secondary bevel, which is the most important one. So the next step is to flatten the back of our iron. So we're just gonna take it out of the honing guide here and bring it to the 1000 grit side and just rub it in like that until we get the back perfectly flat. So this can take a while, and if the blade already has what's known as a back bevel, you can get a really thin ruler or something like that. Let me see if I have one lying about the place. Here we go. So you'd hold it up on the very edge of the diamond stone like that, and you could rub it like that, and that would kind of speed up the process for you. You can do it on plain irons, but not with chisels, so just remember that. But this fella's not too bad, so I'm just gonna keep going and get him flat. So we can see here, the back of the plane is perfectly flat at the edge. So next up, we're gonna put the iron back into the honing guide, and we're gonna sharpen our secondary bevel. So I drew a quick diagram to help you guys understand. You can see here, this is the plane iron that we've just sharpened to 25 degrees. So what we're going to do now is sharpen it to 30 degrees. When we put that in the honing guide and bring it to the stone, it should just take off the very tip. So once we have the primary bevel in place, we don't need to grind that down every single time. So the next time we sharpen this plane iron, we'll be able to bring it straight onto 30 degrees, give it a few passes on the diamond stone, and it should be just as sharp as it was when we have it finished here after the first time. So it says on the side of the honing guide that in order to sharpen it to 30 degrees, we need to project by 38 millimeters. So I have another ruler here now set up. So we're just going to line them up down there, tighten it with our hands first, and then bring it to the screwdriver and just lock it into place. And then all we need to do is bring it onto the grinding stone here, or the diamond stone, and just a few pulls like this. We don't need to grind it forwards and backwards. I find just pulling it like that works best. So we're going to give it a few passes here in the middle. So I lean to one side and I'm going to do 5 pulls. And I'm going to do the same on the other side. And that should give us what's known as a cambered edge, basically a slight curve at the edge of the iron. And that'll stop us from getting kind of one side of the iron tearing into the wood. It should do all the cutting in the center, which is what I want to get here. So after just a few passes on that, I can already see the burr. It's hard to show up on camera, especially when the steel is good. There'll be a smaller burr. So that means it's ready for stropping. So I'm going to take it out of the honing guide there real quick and bring out the strop. As I mentioned before, you can use a stropping compound. You don't need much of it. I just have a tiny finger of it there, and that'll just help us speed up the process here. So what I like to do is have the plane or the iron beveled up and just run it along the leather strop like that. Now that mightn't have removed the bevel or the burr, but when we come around the other side and lift it to about 45 degrees, that fella should have come off by now. So we're just going to rub it along the strop a few times. You can never go with the strop. You have to always pull the iron along against it. If you drove it into it, you'd only end up cutting yourself with the strop. So I'm just going to put it like that for a while, and we should have a lovely polished surface, which is already starting to appear. So just on a visual inspection here, it looks like we have a razor sharp edge. There's actually a mirror finish on the secondary bevel, so hopefully you guys can see that there. Now, normally to test out the sharpness, I like to shave hairs off my arms, but I've been doing a lot of sharpening lately, so we're suffering from a bit of balding. So I've been slowly deforesting my leg down here, so we're going to take the iron to that and see if we can shave that instead. So hopefully you guys can see this and it's in focus, but we're just going to find a patch there that hasn't been shaved yet and just kind of run it down with the grain of the hair, the natural flow even. And you can see there it is taking hairs clean off. So that is a true sign of sharpness. So now that we have our iron sharp as could be, we need to put it back together. So we're going to put the chip breaker back on. See how I'm putting it on at an angle here as to not damage the edge by sliding it over. So we're just going to slide it over like that and kind of push it so that it's just about a millimeter or two over the very edge. So we'll just leave it in there like that now and lock her into place with the screwdriver. So I'm going to wind my plane counterclockwise and drop the iron into it very carefully as to not damage the edge. Once it sits into place there now, we can throw back on the lever cap and away we go. So I have a nice seasoned piece of oak here in front of me now, and I'm just going to try test it out on that. So I retracted the iron before I put it back in, and I'm just going to wind it in ever so slightly each time until I take a bite. So I can already feel there now that it is taking a really thin, wispy shaving on all the high spots. So if I stick at this for a while, I should get a nice clean shaving the whole way along the length of oak. So here we have it, lads. We're taking a nice clean shaving the whole length of it. Now, oak is very open pore. See, there's a lot of kind of holes in the grain, so it might be the best one to be testing on. I remember one time in the TikTok comment section, I called translucent shavings transparent, and I was et alive in the comment section. So this isn't the proper way to use an invoice, but sure, look, who cares? So we have what will hopefully be the seat in my curragh one day. So we're just going to run him along here real quick, joint it all down. And there's a very satisfying sound coming out of him. So there we have it now. We're taking a nice clean shaving the whole way along the board, and there is most definitely light coming through that. So there we have it, lads. We have an iron that is sharp enough to do pretty much every job you will require of a hand plane. We're leaving a beautiful finish behind there after that now. I've been asked a few times to make the tutorial on TikTok, but I felt it was the wrong platform for it. So hopefully this video was of use to some of you who are looking to get a razor sharp edge on some of your tools. Thanks for watching. Talk to you next time. Good luck.